Hello YouTube, welcome back to The Witcher 3 with Lieutenant Joker. It's been a while since I've played, so I don't know exactly where we were going, but I think we're going to the marked location, so I hope we're on the right track here. Take the upper road here. I'm not sure which way I have to take. I just knew that we reloaded last time. No, this can't be right. That's way too steep. So let's go down here. And if possible without breaking our ankles. And I see we also still have a damaged sword. Which of course also isn't ideal, but which one is that actually? Oh great, that's a steel sword. Which is probably the one that we're gonna use most. So we really should get that fixed. Okay, there's tons of wolves down there, so let's try and not go there. Aha.
Bad idea.
Come on! Son of goats!
Okay, let's get out of line of fire of that archer. Oh man. Apparently heavy weapons can go through my block. Okay, that was the... Okay, you I know I can block. Get away from this guy. Okay, come here, you. Come here. Okay, this guy apparently doesn't want to. The shield protecting him against this too? Come here. God damn it. That's gotta hurt. Okay, so... Balin Longsword. Well, that at least means we have an alternative sword for the time being, if our current one really falls apart. I think this Fistek, no wonder you guys can't cut it if you're on drugs. And while we're looting this place, I actually used the time, by the way, if anybody asks me how I'm doing, absolutely no change, everything is still crappy, so yeah, no news, otherwise I would have talked about it. Trying to not do a lot in the recent... Wow, what the hell? Oh, there's another one. Nope. Ooh! Ouch. Okay. I downloaded a new DLC for better finisher moves. I think this one, this is one of them. Holy crap! Jeez. Soaked letter. Anyway, what I was trying to say, I actually managed to finish all the Witcher books, at least, there's still one short storybook that is pretty new, but I think that actually got released after the game started, so I pretty much know all the backstory lore now, all the, well, basically all that is relevant to this story about Ciri and Geralt and Yennefer and all that. I gotta say, some of these books, in my opinion, are not as good as they could be. The author has a little bit of way of writing that I'm not always comfortable with, but the point is, I know a lot more. And there was actually quite a story twist at the end of the last book, which of course I won't spoil, but just saying, if you... I'm pretty sure that if you don't know what happened in that book, it will be spoiled by you for you by the game. I mean, it's kind of obvious that a Let's Play about The Witcher will spoil some stuff anyway, but... Oh, it's another archer. Oh, man. How many guys are there? And how big is this camp? Jeez! Anyway. I guess you should really read those books. Just gonna say about the Geralt saga or the Witcher saga. There's a couple of books, two short story books, which kind of start it all, and then there's a quintology of books. And I was kind of expecting that to be the saga about Geralt, but it's really more the saga of Ciri. In some of the books, Geralt barely does anything, so if you want to read about Geralt, you might be a little bit disappointed when you read those books. In the short story books, he's the main protagonist. In the novels, most of the time Ciri is actually the protagonist, and sometimes Yennefer, sometimes even other people. And that also changes within the books a lot, so... The books are great to get the lore, but don't expect Geralt to always be the most important guy. That might be otherwise a little bit disappointing for you. Just saying. Because I know a lot of people, now that The Witcher 3 is so popular, may want to take a look at the books to get a little bit more info about the lore. Which is certainly a good thing to do. I don't think it's 100% needed for the other two games, but this one is going so deep and you can go to so many places and meet so many people, I think. Which of course hasn't happened yet. I mean, this is still basically a kind of prologue, but I think that will happen because I saw some stuff in the trailers that makes a lot more sense to me now that I read the books, or rather I know who those people are that we meet there. So that might actually be good if you do that. But as I said, don't expect Geralt to be always the most important guy, and also expect a very, very different kind of writing style. The author changes the perspective a lot. You get a story. It's not a story that is being constantly told by this from the same perspective. Parts of the story are being told by people remembering them, then suddenly you jump right into the story again, where the people actually in the present will tell you some stuff, then you got to go back to the future again, where people, sometimes the same people, write their memoirs remembering what happened back then. So it's really confusing at times. I'm not saying it's bad, I'm just saying it's a little bit confusing, and the last book was a little strange in terms of what it did there. And the ending of the last book I didn't like at all, which is kind of good that the games are around, because of them it actually isn't the ending. It's not like that I get to the sad or bad ending or something like that, I just didn't like what it did with it. So it's not a Mass Effect 3 disaster or something like that, but it's different. Anyway, okay, I'm already wandering back, and I kind of wanted to make the tour here. So, okay, we're gonna make this entire tour, and I think then we actually got everything. And then it should be time to get the griffin, right? So let's do that. Let's keep walking. How did I? Oh, there we go. I forgot which key toggled the moving style. Whoa! How do I get down there safest? Girl, can you slide down there? Jeez, a lot of wolves, and I have a damaged sword. So let's try to avoid them. I like wolves in... That's, by the way, one major complaint I have with fantasy games. Most of the time, wolves are enemies, and I know wolves are kind of the scary animal, but and I guess back in these old times when they were really hungry, they would actually attack people and stuff. But honestly, these wolves are in the middle of summer in... I just completed the quest. What quest was that? I have to look into that. Let me finish this. I don't really like that wolves attack people here. I mean, they're not monsters, they're just normal wolves. They're in the middle of a forest with lots of game. Why would they hunt humans? They have more than enough food. Makes no sense whatsoever. And also, I've played other fantasy games where it was kind of a ranger, kind of a... and even druid and stuff like that. And even for those, you can't be friends with the animals, especially wolves. And that kind of always pissed me off a little bit, especially since I like wolves. But anyway, yeah, look at this. Why wouldn't the wolves hunt them instead of me? I'm a lot bigger and a lot more scary. I mean, they do hunt them even. You often see that in the game, which I think is actually great. So why would they hunt me? So what is this?
Strange.
Is that all? Strange? What quest was this? Hill found the instruction mentioned in the notes and found the dessert as cash. What rich find it was? Oh! That was the quest opened by the stuff that I found from these deserters upstairs. Sure, there's something that I needed to read or something. Yeah, there we go. Soak letter, what is this? Villarid. So the mayor of Izima escaped? So there was a spy among those? I didn't get this. I guess there was a spy among those deserters or something? Oh yeah, he actually spied on... Wait a second, what direction is that? That is roughly west. What did he observe from here? There's a windmill. Do I see that on the map? No. Let me mark this spot on the map and see whether that might be the windmill. That actually might be the windmill. And he observed that? Please stay away. I don't have any quarrel with you right now. Let's see. Let's read this again. Back in the camp, brought in heaps of plunder, mostly armor and weapons, but this time a sealed chest too. Towards dusk, command delivered rations of food and drink. Messenger arrived in the camp before dawn, caused Kai to stir. They immediately reorganized a group to transport the chest. After dusk, I'll try to track down what they carried it to. Didn't move the case that far away, just to the abandoned hut near the old mill. Set up a watch so I wasn't able to get closer. Every man in the camp has been drinking since yesterday afternoon. If we attack now, we can obliterate them. Too bad the commander only sent one man to this outpost. I'll try to sneak in tonight. If fortune smiles on me, perhaps one man will be enough. Well, apparently it wasn't. Because you're dead. Why can't I save my game right now? Because there's a wolf nearby? No. Okay. Well. Wolves, leave me alone. I just want to get to that windmill. Preload Igni, I think that kills a wolf nearly instantly. Okay, let's see. So there's a hut here. Is this the place? I think they're hunting something, but not me. So I hope they don't. I don't really like killing wolves in these games, as I mentioned, so I try to avoid them. Especially, hey, I'm called the White Wolf. So why would I kill wolves? What kind of shield was this again? Was this Redania? I'm not sure. Well, the sun is from Is that the Eternal Flame, that one? There's all sorts of crap here. A warg, nah. Okay. I knew you were gonna attack me. And you're no normal wolf, you're kind of a monster, so... I'm completing quests left and right here that I didn't even know were open. Are those kind of quests that, are opened and closed at the same time, or how does that work? Just igniting this because it might keep the wolves away, although... They're just kind of rolling around and having a good time. They don't actually... Oh crap. Please.
Come on.
Yeah, you other guys better run. I don't want to kill any of you. I'm just... here to enjoy the scenery, you know? Okay, I think that was it. So let's quickly check what I just did there. Things are going better and better for us. We've pitched camp in the heart of the forest near the old mill and have already done quite nice for ourselves. Folk are poor, so they say, but squeeze them and something always pops out. Sack of grain here, a few crowns there. Not bad for easy work, certainly better than the army. At least we've got something to fill our bellies, and the risk that we'll pay for all this with our lives, well, it's still less than when we were charging the Nilfs at Natalis' order. Oh, great. So another pack of deserters. Oh, well. Tons of fistic here. I don't even know whether it's legal to sell that. Tons of stuff in here. Kedwani Gambeson. Armor, 29 armor. Well, I'm not a Kedwani, but that's kind of a lot better than what I had. Yeah, that's a lot better than what I had. Do I have anything else that's better than what I'm wearing? You do. Trousers. Oh, not really. Yeah, the rest seems to be... not so great. Okay, no, my silver sword is actually broken. Okay. Well, I really need to get this repaired, so, I guess we should probably go... to the village. And since that's a little far away, I'm going to check for the mill. Quick travel thing. Where was that windmill, actually? This is just a camp near the mill. Where was the actual mill? that was here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Oh yeah, we were there. There was another thing here. Yeah, I've been here before. So, let's travel back to the town. Get our stuff repaired, and I'll do that off screen. Since we're closing our half an hour gameplay, we've tracked pretty much all the side quests. Let me quickly check that quest that we just completed there. Dirty Finds. Geralt found the camp, but the deserters refused to surrender their treasure without a fight. They attacked the Witcher at once, which proved a fatal error. Geralt vanquished them without much trouble, searched the camp, and found a sizable cache of values. So apparently there's quite a bit of deserter stuff here. I'm not sure what would have started those quests. Maybe I should have read more notes or something like that. But seems to be fine as is. I mean, well, there's probably a hint for this stuff hidden somewhere, but I found it anyway. So we've basically took care of all the side quests. I'm going to sell some stuff, re-equip myself, get my sword repaired, because I'm not sure whether I'm going to need it against the Griffin. I don't think so. But just to make sure, because we might actually end the chapter with that and soon start a new chapter, so I want my gear in order. So with that, I'll leave you and say keep your heads down, folks. I'll see you on the next one.